Hi, welcome to Star USA. I am Kaya. Today we have an amazing video prepared for you guys. But before we get started, I want to show what's in front of me here. We have some of Star USA's lineup right here, and we have the flagship Star 9s. Polymer framed, striker fired firearms to steel framed firearms to fully steel framed competition pistol to good old Star 109T. And today I have an awesome group of people here as my guests to try all these firearms out. And they're known as America's finest. Yes, they are our law enforcement professionals who go out there every single day and keep us safe. For that, we are very thankful for them. What do you say? Should we meet them? I think so. Bring it in, guys. Well, first of all, welcome. Thank you for coming out here.
Hey,
appreciate it. How's it going? Thank you. Okay. Thank you for coming out. Thank you. Thank you. How's your day going? Everybody's doing good?
Good. Yeah.
Good.
Very good. Very good. Well, once again, thanks for coming out here. I am very excited to have you guys, you experts, here to try these awesome guns. Why don't I just start with some information about the guns? What do you think? Right? Okay, so what we have here is the Star 9 lineup. We have the polymer framed, striker fired Star 9 lineup, and then we also have steel framed firearms. We got the beautiful K12 Sport competition pistol over there as well. So when it comes to Star 9, I'll grab this. This is Star 9T. It's a just your regular full-size pistol. Polymer framed, striker fired, 4.4 inch barrel. It's got no external safety. As we can tell, like we can look at Star 9 Sport over here, there's an external safety. You guys can see this. But this firearm does not have external safety, and the trigger pull is right about 5 pounds, and the barrel is 4.4 inches in length. And when it comes to side straps, like in the back straps, they're completely interchangeable for your liking. And then we have this beautiful Star 9 Sport. And you can tell the barrel is right off the bat. When you first look at this firearm, you could tell the barrel is longer than your regular Star 9. Look at the camera right here. You can see that. The barrel is 5.2 inches in length. Everything else about the same. There's external safety. And if you don't want this external safety, some people don't, it's very easy to remove. You can do it yourself. Star USA actually sells the pin. So go to StarUSA.com. You can get that ordered up. Or you can go ahead and ship this gun to Star USA, and Star USA will do it for you and ship it back to you. It's extremely simple, and your gun will look exactly like Star 9T. No external safety, and you can tell there's a little pin right here. That's about it. So Star 9 Sport is got a little bit difference right here. There's the slide cutouts that actually reduces the weight, also cools the barrel down, and which improves the performance of the firearm. Also, as you see on all the Star 9 lineup, there's front serrations, because if you want to do a little press check, or if you want to rack the firearm from the front, some people like to do that, so it kind of gives you a better grip as well. And also we have, that was the Star 9T, this is the full size, then we have the Star 9 Sport, the longer barrel one, and then we have this beautiful Star 9C compact. It is got only 4 inches in barrel. The barrel length is 4 inches. Everything else is about the same. And when it comes to safety, there is no external safety, as you can see. Same thing with the front serrations and the rear serrations. Picatinny rails on all Star 9s. And when it comes to backstrap and side straps, side panels are all interchangeable on all Star 9 models. Other than that, that's about it. And then I have this beautiful, beautiful K12 right here that I want to talk about. So K12, get right here. If you look at this firearm right here, it's a beauty. So this is just K12 Sport. And what differentiates this from K12 Sport X is the slide cutouts. But, and also this has a flared magazine well. That one does not. But it's a really precision firearm. If you want to really get out there and compete, this is the firearm for you. It's incredible. And when it comes to trigger, I'm gonna make sure this firearm is, by the way, just a record, for the record, all these firearms have been checked for clear safety by me numerous times, but I'm still gonna go ahead and do that. It's clear. Clear. All right, this firearm is now clear. So what I wanna show you, what I wanna talk about is the trigger. Trigger has a little screw right here. You can actually adjust this screw to make the reset shorter or longer depending on your liking. Some people like it long, some people just like it short for a faster fire. So when you press on this like that, see, this has got a little bit longer reset. And if you actually screw this one in a little bit further, it'll actually help you reduce the reset on it. So basically you're modifying the trigger to your liking when it comes to your press. That's about it for K12. Put this one right back where it was. And now I want to talk about the SAR 109T. Oh, it's a beautiful gun. Yeah, there we go. This firearm is also empty. For SAR 109T, it's got 8.6 inch barrel and also has 32 round magazine. It's a very fun gun. It's incredibly, incredibly fun. And the recoil management is phenomenal, which I'm gonna be asking every single one of you after you fire this, what are your thoughts on the recoil management? It almost feels like you're shooting, it's nothing. So it's like a BB gun, very, very good. It also comes with collapsible sights. Any questions about this?
No, let's go shoot it.
Let's go shoot it, all right. Let's get out there and let's shoot it. All right, we're ready to get out there and send some rounds down range. Let's go. These guys love these guns so much. They just lined up SAR 9C compact. They're loving the size and how accurately it fires. And they're literally over there in line, just like, hey, I wanna shoot, I wanna shoot. Got some mags for me, I'm gonna shoot some too. All right, it was a lot of fun. We had a really good time and we came to the end. Let's find out how our friends in law enforcement thought about our guns. Jared, what do you think?
It was good. You know, I've been doing firearm instructor for about 8 years now. Been in law enforcement for the better part of 16, so been around a handful of guns, obviously, for a long time. And always good to get your hands on something new and try some stuff out. I was like to see what SAR arms bring to the table. Kind of felt there was that niche market kind of for everybody, from a plinker on the weekend up until you guys have your competitive series guns and different things like that. So I like the forward serrations on a lot of them. I like, you know, they all have appropriate capacity, 15, 17 round capacities, things like that. It's good to see optics ready, options available too for the market, you know, with that kind of being the latest and greatest and what it's going to be. So no, I liked it. It was good.
Nice. Very good to hear. And Jared, what did you think?
I liked them. I think I've been an instructor for about 6 years now, and everybody's got their own, you know, things they look for in a pistol as far as what they think is more important. The grip was very nice. That was one of my favorite things about it. The grip was really nice, and the trigger pull and the trigger reset was very good for compared to other guns that I've shot.
Which gun?
I shot mostly the SAR 9.
SAR 9 platform,
and mostly with the red dots. Wow. And I thought they were very flat shooting.
Nice. Good to hear. Good deal. Matt, what do
you think? Yeah, enjoyed the day. My big takeaway was that K12. Really loved it for competitive shooting and able to adjust that trigger reset.
Nice.
Getting it dialed in right how you want it is good. It's good for that market, and it's good for that type of shooting.
Guys, seriously, thank you. Thank you so much for your time today. I appreciate it. I had a lot of fun. That was a lot of rounds downrange. It was a good time. And I look forward to doing this again. And would you guys be interested coming out again?
Oh, yeah.
All right, guys, that's about it for today. Thanks for tuning in. For more information, don't forget to visit SARUSA.com. And also, don't forget to follow us on our social media networks. Until next time, stay safe out there.